Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to be talking about a skill learned normally in the Algebra 2 level, and that is working with conics, and in particular the parabola. We're going to answer some basic questions that normally help us to graph a parabola. So we're going to find the vertex, the axis of symmetry, the direction of the parabola, and the extreme value of this particular parabola. Starting with the equation that we have here, y equals negative 3/16 times the quantity x plus 2 squared plus 3. We're going to go ahead and subtract 3 from both sides to put this formula into, or to put this function into a form that more closely matches standard form. So it's going to give us y minus 3 is equal to negative 3/16 x plus 2 squared. All we did was move the 3 from the right-hand side of the equal sign to the left-hand side. Now we're in a form that's easier to see what the vertex is. The vertex is going to be negative 2, positive 3, and notice how I took the opposite sign for the numbers that I'm using here. So vertex, negative 2, positive 3. Axis of symmetry in this case for this function is the x value that we see here, x is equal to negative 2. The reason that we know that is because the x value is being squared, so we know the axis of symmetry is going to match the x value that we see in our vertex. Now we're going to go to the direction that this parabola is facing. Again, because the x variable is being squared, the parabola either points up or down. We know that the parabola is going to be pointing in a downward position because p is less than 0. In this case, that is negative 3/16, and that's going to create a parabola that generally looks like this. And again, because it's pointing in a downward manner, that means we have a maximum value, and that maximum value again is going to be shown as the y-coordinate of the vertex. So the max in this case would be where y is equal to 3. Now we're going to find some intercepts. We're going to start off with the y-intercept, because we want these intercepts to help us graph the equation. Normally when you're graphing by hand, it's really handy to have these extra points, but when you're using a computer or other tools, it's really not that important. But as you work in school and learn more about the section, of course your instructors are going to want you to actually find these extra points as you graph by hand. So to find the y-intercept, that means we have to set the x variables to 0. So using the equation we have above, y minus 3 is equal to negative 3/16, changing that x variable to a 0 and rewriting the rest. Using the order of operations, I need to evaluate the 0 plus 2 in parentheses to get 2, and again, continue with the rest, which is the squaring. Now I take the 2 raised to the second power, that gives me 4. And then I notice that the 16 here and the 4 have a common factor of 4. So 4 divided by 4 is 1, and 16 divided by 4 is 4. So that's going to leave me with y minus 3 is equal to negative 3/4. My goal here is to isolate the y variable because I need to find out what y is equal to. So I'm going to add 3 to both sides, and that's going to give me y is equal to negative 3/4 plus 3/1. I'm using 3/1 because I know I'm going to have to add these two numbers together, these two fractions together, so I'm using my understood denominator of 1 for the whole number 3. At this point, I need to find my common denominator. My common denominator between the numbers 4 and 1 is simply 4. My first fraction stays the same at negative 3/4. My second fraction, 3/1, becomes 12/4, because 12 divided by 4 gives me 3, so that is my equivalent fraction. Now I'm just going to add my numerators. Negative 3 plus 12 gives me positive 9, and my denominator stays the same at 4. Never add those denominators. And then I want to take a step further and divide 9 by 4, so I come up with my decimal equivalent of 2.25. So I just found that when the x value is 0, I'm going to have a y value of 2.25. Now I'm going to continue on to find my x-intercepts. To find my x-intercepts, I'm going to substitute in a value of 0 for y and then solve for x. Again, going back to the equation here, which is in near standard form, 0 minus 3 is equal to negative 3/16 times the quantity x plus 2 squared. I need to, well, my first step is going to be to divide both sides by negative 3/16. And that's going to leave me with negative 3 over 1 times the reciprocal of this denominator. Whenever you divide by a fraction, you need to multiply by the reciprocal. In this case, the reciprocal is going to be negative 16/3 equal to negative 3/16 divided by negative 3/16 simplifies down to 1, and that just leaves me with x plus 2 quantity squared. I notice here that I can simplify these fractions. I know that negative 3 and 3 have a common factor of 3. So negative 3 divided by 3 gives me negative 1, and 3 divided by 3 gives me 1. When you multiply fractions, you multiply across your numerators and across your denominators. So negative 1 times negative 16 gives me a positive 16. And then I'm going to rewrite what's off to the right-hand side of my equal sign. Now I notice that one side is squared. I need to get rid of that square so I can figure out what the value of x is. So to undo that, I take the square root of both sides of this equation. So the square root of 16 plus and minus 4. The reason why that's plus and minus is because if I take negative 4 and square it, I'm going to get 16. If I take positive 4 and square it, I still get 16. So I have two solutions for the square root of 16. And then the radical undoes this square. So this just comes out to be x plus 2. Now I'm going to separate this equation into two separate equations so I can evaluate the plus sign, which is 4 equals x plus 2, and the negative side, which is negative 4 is equal to x plus 2. Here, to solve for x, I need to subtract 2 from both sides. So that there is going to give me 2 is equal to x. And here on the other side, I'm going to subtract 2 from both sides. And that's going to give me negative 6 is equal to x. Now I found, now I know that my x values when y is 0 is going to be at two points, at point 2, 0, and also at point negative 6, 0. So I've got my two x-intercepts. Over here I have my y-intercept. I have my vertex, my axis of symmetry, and my extreme value. Now what I'm going to do is flip over to a graph that I have here. And on this graph, we're going to take a look to verify those values. We see up here that our vertex is negative 2, 3, like we stated previously on the other page. Over here to the right, we see that our y-intercept is at point 0, 2.25. Even farther to the right, to find our x-intercept, we find one of those points to be 2, 0. Over here to the far left, we find that other x-intercept to be negative 6, 0. We also talked about the axis of symmetry, and we see the axis of symmetry is here at x equals negative 2 to create a vertical line. And then we see that our maximum value is found here at y equals 3, which shows that the parabola is pointing down and that y value is the greatest value. So again, we've ran through all the pertinent information for graphing a parabola. Thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe to Speller Tutorial Services at our YouTube channel. Thanks again.